Hello dear students, my name is Gulzat Aalieva, and today I will continue my lectures in philosophy, and today I want to suggest for you a new topic, which is laws of dialectics. Traditionally, we will start our lecture from lecture plan. So you see here, our lecture consists of four main topics. During lecture, I will try to explain the meaning of every topic. The first topic of our lecture is the concept of law and its varieties. The laws of dialectics are the laws that determine the development process. The basic laws of dialectics include the law of unity and the fight or struggle of opposites, the law of the transition of quantitative changes into qualitative and vice versa, the law of negation of the negation. These laws disclose respectively source, mechanism, and direction of development. So here on this picture, you see the scheme of the laws of dialectics in Russian language. So here you may read the main laws of dialectics, the law of dialectics, and you see three main laws of dialectics. And the law of transition, quantitative change into new quality. Here the law of unity and struggle of opposites. And here the law of negation of the negation, or the law of double negations. The second topic is the law of unity and the fight of opposites. The core or the center of dialectics is called the law of unity and struggle of opposites, as well as this law explains the source or origin of development. Metaphysics names the external first impulse or God as a source of development. According to this law of dialectics, each object and phenomenon is characterized by internal opposites that are in unity and interaction, at the same time in the struggle among themselves. The whole world consists of the unity and struggle of opposites. For example, according to the folk medicine of the Kyrgyz people, the human body consists of two opposite principles, hot beginning and cold beginning. Health is the equality between hot and cold principles of the body. Illness is an imbalance between hot and cold beginnings in the body. And doctor's task is not to treat the patient, but to restore the disturbed balance. For this reason, Kyrgyz doctors treated their patients with a special diet. If the patient had a cold illness, he was given a high calorie and hot food with meat. If the patient had a hot illness, he was offered low calorie food, fruit, or just water. So you understood, if patient has a cold illness, he should drink, he should eat high calorie food. If he has hot illness, he should eat just low calorie food or just drink water. In the law of unity and struggle of opposites, there are two concepts that are close in content, opposites and contradictions. Are they identical or is there a difference between them? Yeah, they are close but different in content concepts. What are opposites? The opposite is a form, a stage of difference at which some properties, signs, tendencies inherent in an object as a system mutually deny, exclude each other. For example, good, evil, white, black, day, night, life, death, male, female, etc. So you should understand the opposite is a quality of material things and phenomena to occupy some extra places in some system, like good and evil, black and white, etc. What is contradiction? If opposites are quality of material things and phenomena, so contradictions is always a relationship between opposite parties in which they not only mutually exclusive, mutually exclude, mutually deny, mutually ignore, but also mutually condition, mutually determine each other. For example, the relationship between good and evil, life and death, health and illness, rich and poor, old and young are always contradictory. The being of the world and the life of people continue to develop thanks to opposites and contradictions. For example, a person is forced to create a family life with a member of the opposite gender to continue the human race. Because if society will consist just of male, so society never will develop. Also, the same situation, if society consists of just female, also society never will develop, because it is impossible. Just such opposites like male and female can be the reason of development. This is a vital requirement or the law of dialectics. The development of society is impossible without such opposites like rich and poor, also young people and old people, educated people and uneducated people, etc. Just these opposites can be at the root of development of society or other phenomena. Negative phenomena always help to recognize and appreciate positive phenomena. There is no bad without good, so here you can see. For example, illness helps to value health. The absence of children helps to value having children. Betrayal helps to value true friendship, etc. This is the law of dialectics. The unity of opposites is always temporary and relative, and the struggle between opposites is eternal and absolute. For example, a family consists of a temporary unity of such opposites like man and woman, husband and wife, parents and children, old and young, etc. However, after 20-25 years, family unity falls, because children will have their own family. But anyway, opposites will exist eternal, such opposites like day and night, rich people and poor people, white and black, etc. They will exist eternal, but unity of opposites, it is just temporary. I can give another examples. For example, the unity of body and soul can exist only 75 or 1,000 years, after which death occurs. The unity of classmates can exist only 5 years, after which they will disperse to different countries and areas. For this reason, the famous British Prime Minister Winston Churchill said, "England has no eternal allies. England has eternal interests, and it are always at odds with the interests of its allies." So you understood the first law, or the law of unity and struggle of opposites, can explain the root of development, and you also understood the root of developments are opposites and contradictions. So the second law of dialectics is the law of mutual transition of quantitative change into new quality. The law of the transition of quantitative change into new quality explains the mechanisms of development using the following concepts: quantity, quality, measure, jump, or leap. So pay your attention, I want to give the explanation of definition of every this concept. What is quantity? Quantity is a category that expresses the external and formal relationship of objects or their parts, as well as properties, connections indicated by numbers like value, speed, the degree of manifestation of a particular quality or feature. So here you see some numbers these numbers, they express just external features. For example, one rabbit or one chicken. So three rabbits or four cats. So different quantity expresses the external relationship of between different things and phenomena. What is quality? Quality is a philosophical category that expresses the totality of essential science features and properties that distinguish one object or phenomenon from others and give it certainty. For example, by quality, rabbit is not cat. A cat is not chicken because they have their own quality. For example, if quantity asks for the question how many, how much, quality always answers for the question what kind. For example, young, old, strong, weak, useful, useless, etc. They can be examples of quality. Next concept is measure. Measure is a philosophical category that expresses the organic unity of the qualitative and quantitative determination of an object or phenomenon. So you should understand during a small time, during temporary time, qualitative and quantitative determination can be in unity, in some unity, and this temporary unity is named measure. For example, from 0 to 100 degrees Celsius is a measure of liquid water. So here you see three states of three conditions of water. So I told you from 0 to 100 degrees of Celsius, it is a measure of liquid water. Below 0 degrees, water turns into ice. It is no liquid condition, it is solid condition. Above 100 degrees, water turns into steam or gas. So it is another gaseous condition, another condition. So you are future doctors, and I think this information will be useful for you, measures of human age. So here you see some table which consists of three columns: quantity, measure, and quality. I told you sometimes quantity and quality can be in temporary unity, and this unity is named the measure. For example, quantity from 0 to 12. So newborn child, from newborn child till 12 years old, this measure is named the childhood, and during this period, children will have such quality like naive, superactive, gullible, etc. From 12 to 18, this measure is named teenager. So quality inquisitive, outlook, ambitious. From 18 till 40 years old, This measure is named youth. So quality, first life lessons, finding yourself, ability to protect other people, responsibility, etc. From 40 to 60 years old, measure is named maturity, so quality, responsibleness, experience, life baggage, etc. From 60 to 75 years old, measure is wisdom, and quality also wisdom, wise people. And from 75 and more, this measure is old age. And old people, they have also their special qualities. You are future doctors, and you should know some examples about which belong to law of mutual transition of quantitative change into new quality. In medicine, the concept of measure is denoted by the concept of norm. For example, normally a person's body temperature is 36.6 degrees. During raising or decreasing of this norm, a person begins to ill, to be ill, to be have to have some problems and troubles. Normal blood pressure is 120 to 80 mmHg. During raising or decreasing of this norm, a person begins to feel discomfort. The normal reproductive period of a person is from 18 till 45 years. God gave people 25 or 30 years to have normal offspring. Until the age of 18 or after 45, the body cannot give a child. The length of the uterus in a woman of reproductive age is from 5 to 7 centimeters. The anomalies associated with the hypoplasia of the uterus, small, underdeveloped, infantile or infant uterus, or uterine hyperplasia, which is bigger than norm uterus, the pregnancy becomes problematic. So in future, you will have such cases and such patients. So everything should be in measure, should be in norm. Next, the concept of the law of mutual transitions of quantitative change into new quality is jump or leap. Jump is a process of transition of quantitative changes into qualitative ones, which begins with the destruction of the boundary of measure. There are two types of jump or leap. The first, evolution. Here, quantitative change pass into a new quality over a long period of time and gradually. For example, biological evolution, which duration equals millions of years. Another example, evolution of society, which equals thousands and hundreds of years. Next example is evolution of human personality. So it takes whole life. The second type of jump is named revolution. Here, quantitative change turn into a new quality during a short time. For example, in October 1917, the October Socialist Revolution took place in the Russian Empire, which caused the following cardinal qualitative changes that occurred in a short time. The first, Russian Kingdom became the Soviet Union. It was completely another country. The second, aristocracy gave way to democracy. It is completely another political regime. Next, capitalism gave way to socialism, so it is also completely another formation, political and economical formation. Next one, private property has been replaced by collective property. It is also another completely another qualitative situation, qualitative case. And one more example, the religious state became an atheistic state. It is also another completely another qualitative condition. Special political events took place in Kyrgyzstan in 2005, 2010 and 2019. However, these events did not lead to dramatic qualitative changes. After these events, one political clan changed another political clan. For this reason, these events cannot be called a revolution. They can be called a political and clan Q. If evolution is inherent in nature, in society, and in thinking, revolution is inherent only in society. In nature, the revolution is always painful. For example, mutation that occur after nuclear test or environmental disasters. Look at this child, so he became a victim of some negative factors. Thus, the law of the mutual transition of qualitative changes into a new quality suggests that all changes in the world don't occur immediately, but through long, gradually accumulating quantitative shifts. The boundaries of the existence of each object are determined by quantitative parameters. The ratio of the quality of an object and its possible quantitative change that do not lead to a revision of its quality is called a measure. Conversely, a qualitative change in an object also determines its new quantitative parameters. So next law, the last law is the law of negation of the negation or the law of double negations. And this law characterizes the direction of development that is constantly going from simple to complex, from weak to strong, from lowest to highest. Any developing system goes through a number of the following interrelated stages: thesis, antithesis, and synthesis. So the law of negation of the negation or the law of double negations reveals the mechanisms of continuity. According to the German philosopher George Wilhelm Hegel, each development resembles a spiral, and each turn of the spiral consists of three stages or triad. The first, thesis, the second, antithesis, and last one is synthesis. What is thesis? Thesis is a statement of something or a starting position of development. For example, look at this picture. In the spring, buds bloom on the branches of tree. So it is a starting position of development of these buds. Look at this picture. So it is antithesis. Antithesis is the denial of a thesis or initial position of development. Gradually, the buds disappear and flowers appear in their place. Here, flowers deny buds because flowers are not buds. So it is antithesis. And last one is synthesis, is the denial of antithesis or the denial of denial. Through synthesis, two conflicting ideas are reconciled to form a new one. For example, the end result of a development is the fruit, you see, which arose as a synthesis of buds and flowers. So every development goes through thesis, antithesis, and synthesis. So there are a lot of examples. I want to give some examples to explain the meaning of this law. Thesis is a newborn child. For example, thesis is a newborn child. He is helpless and weak. He needs protection and care. He has no life experience. It is thesis because it is a starting position of development in the form of child, newborn child. Antithesis. Gradually, the child becomes a strong person who has life experience and can take care of others. Stage is synthesis. Step by step, then a strong person becomes a helpless and weak old man. However, unlike a newborn child, an old man has such new qualities as life experience and wisdom. Thus, at the highest stage of development, a certain repetition of certain features that characterize the initial stage occurs. One more example. Thesis. The beginning of a cold. The person feels some symptoms of the disease, but he is able to work. Antithesis. At the peak of a cold, a person has a high fever, headaches, and is not efficient. Synthesis. After a cold, a person is able to work again. However, a person has a new quality. This quality is the appearance of immunity. There are two types of denial. The first is metaphysical negation, and the second is dialectical negation. What is the difference between these forms of, or between these types of denial? Metaphysical denial, here the new completely denies and ignores the old. For example, in 1937, during the Stalinist repression in the Soviet Union, more than 3 million highly qualified officers were shot because they were from the family of the old system or from the royal family, from the family of rich people. After 4 years, in 1941, the war broke out between the Soviet Union and Germany. There were no experienced officers with higher education in the Soviet Union because all of them were shot 4 years ago. Then the Soviet Union was forced to early assign the officer rank to young guys who graduated from school. But anyway, these guys, they were uneducated and they had not life experiences, military experiences. That's why during the earlier period of the war, Soviet Union was in very high trouble. The second form of negation is dialectical negation. And unlike metaphysical negation, dialectical negation does not ignore the old. Here, the new arises from the best elements of the old. So you see here this picture. So new arises from the best elements of the old. This is the principle of continuity. So students, it is enough for this lecture. So during this lecture, you understood the meaning of law. Also, you understood the essence of three laws of dialectics. So I hope during the practical class, you will explain these laws of dialectics. And during explanation, please try to give medical examples. Thank you very much. Goodbye.